King takes, it could be sound, but there is some flow. So white has a very strong move. I mean, it's possible to take, of course, by king, but guys, let's explain. I mean, tell me what is the flow here or how to play for white now. So this is exactly how method of elimination working. I mean, you have, yes, Vedant, well done. So Vedant found this concrete and very strong reply. And actually, unfortunately, there is no defense. E5 is very strong. E5 is coming. And unfortunately, there is no defense. So this is exactly how method of evaluation works, actually. I mean, for instance, you can play this, but E5 is very strong and it's just lost. So unfortunately for black is it's just losing. Yeah, I mean, good or bad, you have to play e takes just to make sure you are not losing at least. So maybe it's a bit better for white, but actually I'm not sure about whether it's better for white, because then I have some counterplay on the dark squares. Also queen c5, knight e5, also c5, semi-open. So black has some decent counterplay, so it's about equal. So let's go next. So now it's white to move. So now I can provide you two choices. So first choice, bishop f4. And the second one, the more concrete, knight takes f7. So guys, let me know. You have to calculate a bit and let me know which one is better. And of course, this is about evaluation also. You have always evaluate your lines. I mean, otherwise it doesn't make sense to calculate something if you are not evaluating properly. Yes, Vedant, well done. And what is your evaluation? So let me show. This is not so difficult one. Yes, the problem is, I mean, yes, of course, take, yes. And the problem is white is better in this kind of end games normally, because yes, and tactical explanation, you can take here by simply because you are losing simply after rook e8. Yes, and more or less always in this kind of end games, white is clearly better because, let's say, here actually bishop f4 is very strong also. But let's say if you play slowly something like this, white is still better because on the two flanks, actually, rook is better than two pieces. Rook, I mean, rook and two pawns normally. Normally you have to, bishop f4 is very strong. Now black has a big troubles here, something like this and something like this. Okay, it's not winning, but white is definitely better. So yes, and bishop f4, this is the second choice actually, but let's say knight a5, bishop c2, okay, maybe white has more active position, maybe b4, knight c4 is possible. Okay, maybe it's a bit better for white, but nothing special. I mean, it's very hard to convert to something serious. I mean, might be a very slight advantage for white. So let's go for the next position. Yes, here. Yes, here actually white can take on e5. Or white can play just knight d2. So this is the question, how to play. Of course, the first question, whether it's possible to take on e5. So first of all, you have to answer the question whether it's possible to take on e5. If it's not that clear, then you can make another choice.